My name is Dr. Zahra Al-Sammak. I work in Salmaniya Medical Complex in Bahrain for the last 21 years. I'm a consultant anesthetist, a senior consultant anesthetist. I was the chairperson of the anesthesia department in Salmaniya till February 2011. For 5 years, since 2006. I'm married to Dr. Ghassan Dheif. We have 3 children. Fatima, my daughter, she's the eldest. She's 18 years old. She's in her final year of school. Mohammed is 14 years old, and Yusuf is 12 years old.
My name is Ghassan Ahmad Dheif. I'm a senior consultant in oral maxillofacial surgery at Salmaniya Medical Complex. I was the chairman of the department for 3.5 years, from 2006 till 2010. I work at Salmaniya for the last 21 years.
We met in the hospital, actually, in Salmaniya when we were interns. He studied in Saudi Arabia. I studied in Bahrain, the Arabian Gulf University. So we met when we were interns in Salmaniya.
As a matter of fact, I met Zahra even well before. Maybe she can. I'm sure she still remembers that. We were doing some summer holidays training in Salmaniya, and we met at that time. But that was very short. Time that we met, and at that time we didn't know each other. It was just a casual gathering with all those who were studying, and they were doing just summer training. But at that time we didn't fall in love. We fell in love well after that, but I still remember those moments.
I think being doctors made them, as Ghassan said, do the maximum of revenge, and I think we got more attention in case of punishment. I don't think anybody else, except maybe the politicians, was punished as we were, and all aspects. It's not only the physical torture, it's the psychological torture, suspension, the future. I mean, this will affect our future very badly, and I'm sure they know about that, and this is their plan, and this is what they want to achieve.
They've targeted the elite doctors, those really who stood very bravely and say the right thing. They've done the right thing, so that's why they wanted to maximize the revenge on us. In most instances, when I was in prison or when I was in detention before I was transferred to the prison, they were stressing exclusively on being a doctor, being highly income, having a private practice. What else you want? I said, I don't want to have anything else. They think that we have done what we have done because we were seeking a higher official positions.
It affected our case a lot. I think without the international pressure, we would still be in prison. They fabricated charges, and they tried, you know, to do the maximum to us. But with the international pressure, I think they are going back, and they are thinking about what they've done to us. I think our case wouldn't continue because of the international pressure.
Our case wouldn't stand, as a matter of fact, long in court because of the international pressure, obviously. If we were left alone without any backup from the international community speaking out on our behalf, we would be still in jail, I would say, and those sentences will be applied immediately. But obviously, the international pressure have yielded something which is our release, and slowly the government are responding, I would say, positively. First of all, the confessions now have been dropped, few charges have been dropped, although the international community, they demand dropping all the charges. This may not come, still the government may not respond, but we will rely a lot on the international pressure, and we advise our colleagues all over the world to continue the pressure till the government responds positively and drop all the charges.
Can you talk a little bit about how you're trying as a family to heal as a family?
Being husband and wife, and this greatly involved in this problem, especially having a lot of charges like what we are blamed for, obviously made the situation worse for us. As you've said yourself, that if only the husband or the wife was imprisoned, then it would be much easier. At least you have another person who's working, he can carry out the other duties, he will have some sort of income and support for the family and for the children, and he can look after the other part of life. But being husband and wife obviously put a lot of trauma, not only to ourselves, but also to our children, to the whole family as well. That, of course, affected us significantly. We feel insecure, especially that I'm supposed to be in prison for 15 years and Zahra for 5 years. And if these sentences get applied, then obviously our children will be lost. By the time we are out, our children will be, Fatima, for example, will be in her 30s. Muhammad will be in his late 20s. So it was really a very hard situation that we are living at the moment. We think a lot of the future, although we try to live our life day by day, but still we continuously think of the future and what will be the sake of our children if these sentences get applied.
Well, it certainly brought us together closer as a family, not only in the context of our small family, but the bigger family altogether. We are very close to each other. We are supporting each other. I remember when Ghassan was in, of course, when both of us were in, both his parents and my mother used to stay with my children, used to sleep with my children. And when I was released and Ghassan was in, his parents used to be with me all the time, and my mother was sleeping with me in the house. Now we are doing, you know, we are almost together all the time to support each other. And it certainly lessens the effect of what's happening, being together. And we always have hope that this thing will end and the truth will prevail at one time, at one day.
That's something that gave you any kind of hope.
To be honest with you, I always had the hope that one day I will be out. I always think that this will not last long, and I still live this belief. People call me over optimistic, but I think I live the reality, because the truth will always prevail.
What gave me hope, I think, is my children. When I was inside, all the time I was thinking about them and how they will manage without me. But the first time they gave me to call them, which was after 10 days of my detention when I first called them, I found my daughter very strong, and she was talking to me. Of course, she was upset and she was, you know, depressed. But she managed, and she was giving me hope, and she was supporting me, and she was giving me the strength. So I was telling myself, this is my daughter, so why should I be depressed and why should I be hopeless? Of course, I'll go out and support them and continue raising them and, you know, giving them what they want. So I think that phone call pushed me. Yeah, definitely.